Immaculate Mother, to you do we plead. Yes, God our Father, for help in our need. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. We pray for our country, the land of our birth. We pray for all nations, that peace be on earth. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria. Ave, Ave, Ave Maria.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, today we're celebrating the memorial of our Blessed Mother, being the first Saturday of the month, and also tomorrow we'll be celebrating the birthday of our Blessed Mother. So today we're offering this Mass in memory of our devotion to the Mother of our Lord Jesus Christ. And also we pray for all the intentions that have been placed on this altar, for all the people that have requested our prayers, and especially for the victims of war and violence elsewhere in the world. Let us now call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You plead for us at the right hand of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant us, O merciful God, protection in our weakness, that we, who keep the memorial of the Holy Mother of God, may, with the help of her intercession, rise up from our iniquities. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, learn from myself and Apollos not to go beyond what is written, so that none of you will be inflated with pride in favor of one person over against another. Who confers distinction upon you? What do you possess that you have not received? But if you have received it, why are you boasting as if you did not receive it? You are already satisfied. You have already grown rich. You have become kings without us. Indeed, I wish that you had become kings, so that we also might become kings with you. For as I see it, God has exhibited us apostles as the last of all, like people sentenced to death, since we have become a spectacle to the world, to angels and men alike. We are fools on Christ's account, but you are wise in Christ. We are weak, but you are strong. You are held in honor, but we in disrepute. To this very hour, we go hungry and thirsty. We are poorly clad and roughly treated. We wander about homeless and we toil. working with our own hands. When ridiculed, we bless. When persecuted, we endure. When slandered, we respond gently. We have become like the world's rubbish, the scum of all, to this very moment. I am writing you this not to shame you, but to admonish you as my beloved children. Even if you should have countless guides to Christ, yet you do not have many fathers, for I became your father in Christ Jesus through the gospel. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is near to all who call upon Him.
The Lord is near to all who call upon Him.
The Lord is just in all His ways and holy in His works. The Lord is near to all who call upon Him, to all who call upon Him in truth.
The Lord is near to all who call upon Him.
He fulfills the desire of those who fear Him. He hears the cry and saves them. The Lord keeps all who love Him, but all the wicked He will destroy.
The Lord is near to all who call upon Him.
May my mouth speak the praise of the Lord, and may all flesh bless His holy name forever and ever.
The Lord is near to all who call upon Him. Please all stand.
Alleluia, 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 Alleluia. I am the way and the truth and the life, says the Lord, no one comes to the Father except through me. Alleluia, 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 Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While Jesus was going through a field of grain on a Sabbath, His disciples were picking the heads of grain, rubbing them in their hands, and eating them. Some Pharisees said, "Why are you doing what is unlawful on the Sabbath?" Jesus said to them in reply, "Have you not read what David did when he and those who were with him were hungry? How he went into the house of God, took the bread of offering, which only the priests could lawfully eat, ate of it, and shared it with his companions? Then he said to them, 'The Son of Man is Lord of the Sabbath.'" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear friends, if your 10-year-old son or daughter asks you, "Why are you a Christian?" What do you find attractive in the Christian faith? Or if you have some friends who are Muslim or Hindus or Buddhists who are non-Christians ask you, "What is the difference between the Christian faith and other faiths?" What would your answer be? We pray the rosary. That is what makes us uniquely Christian. We celebrate the Mass. Is that what makes us uniquely, fundamentally different from other religions? Is it our devotion to our Blessed Mother or to the saints, all of what I said, rosary, mass, devotion to the saints, all of these are very uniquely Catholic. But they are not the essentially unique part of Christian faith. So what makes the Christian faith Christian? It is none other than Jesus Christ. It is Christ who is at the core of our Christian faith. Ang ating pong mga misa, rosaryo, lahat pong yan ay kailangan at magandang ating debosyon sa mahal na pong Nazareno. Lahat po yan. They're all very Catholic. And yes, they are important to our Catholic faith, but that is not the core of the Christian faith. That's the problem of the Jews during the time of Jesus. Gulong-gulo sila sa lahat mga commandments. May 10 commandments and there were 600 more laws that they had to follow, that they lost sense of what was essential to the Jewish faith. And Jesus summed up all the laws point to love of God equals love of neighbor. Yan ang sinabi ni Jesus. That they have lost track of what is the core of the Jewish faith. In our Christian faith, we have lost track of the fact that our Christian faith must be centered on the person of Jesus Christ. That is what makes us Christian. One author says, take the word Christ out of the word Christian, what remains? The letters I-A-N. I am nothing. We are nothing. Our belief, our faith is nothing if we don't have a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. If we don't know who Jesus Christ is. And when I say we don't know who Jesus Christ is, it's not the information about where he was born, who were his parents, where he suffered, where he lived. No. These are all intellectual, mental bits of information. When we say we know Christ as a friend, that we have a relationship with Christ. Ilan sa inyo ang nakikipag-usap kay Jesus, na parang kaibigan? Because relationship is basically a kind of friendship. If we love our faith, if we say we are Christians, we should have a BFF relationship with Jesus Christ. Tapat mag-BFF tayo. And how do BFFs talk to each other? They talk about joys, they talk about funny things, they talk about, you know, many other things. Because we have to look at Christ as a real person. How many of you have talked to Jesus like sitting down face to face, looking at his eyes, at sinasabi, Jesus, alam nyo, today I had problem with this, but I had difficulty, but I was able to do it. Alam nyo, Jesus, na may problema ako, pero, you know, okay lang. How many of us talk to Jesus like that? Because that's how we talk to friends, right? Hindi ba? When we talk to friends, we don't kneel before them, right? We should kneel before Jesus in respect, yes. But we must have that deeper relationship to say, hey, Jesus, kumusta na? Nakasakay ka sa jeepney. Ay, naku, Lord, pupunta ako sa aking, bibisitahin ko aking kaibigan. Pagdasal niyo po, kumusta na po? Okay naman po ako. Pagkatapos ito, magluluto ako, kakain kami. How many of you talk to Jesus like you talk to Jesus? You know, Jesus, you don't need to text him. Any moment, any time, any place, you can get to communicate with Jesus. Kailangan kaibigan natin, BFF natin si Jesus. Otherwise, wala pong kwenta ang ating pong pananampalataya kung ating pong lang pinupuntahan si Jesus para hingan siya ng ating mga petisyon, ng ating mga intensyon, ating mga dasal-dasalin at mga ating binibigyan importansya sa buhay. Hindi. Kailangan deeper than that. That every moment, hindi ba ganyan kayo pag may ano kayo, te-text yung kaibigan nyo, o ano yung, does they text back to you? That's another thing. sa relationship po, may give and take. Hindi lang take and take. Alam niyo po, marami sa atin papasok sa simbahan, magsasalita sa Poong Nazareno, ito po ang aking mga pangangailangan. Cure the sick, help me in my job, ito po yung mga ano. Sasabihin nyo, may enumeration kayo, may listahan kayo. Pagkatapos nyo sabihin nyo, anong gagawin nyo? Tatayo na lang kayo. Sige po, by Jesus. How many of us give Jesus the time to talk back to us? Madalas sa ating pagdarasal, tayo lang ang pong daldal ng daldal kay Jesus. Ganyan ba ang BFF? Kung ganyan kayo sa BFF nyo, i-FO kayo ng BF nyo. Ano yung FO? Friendship over. I-FO daw kayo. Di ba? Kung kayo lang ang dakdak ng dakdak sa dasal ninyo, kung kayo lang ang petisyon ng petisyon, hindi nyo binibigyan chance si Jesus na magsalita sa inyo, ay hindi kayo BFF ni Jesus. User-friendly lang kayo. User-friendly. Okay? At pag binigay ni Jesus, ay, thank you, Lord, thank you. Thank you to sa binigay niyo. Okay, bye. Pag kayo ba nakikipag-usap sa telepono, hello, achu-chu-chu-chu, dal-dal ka ng dal-dal, o sige, bye, puk, bababa mo na telepono. Kawawa naman yung kausap mo. Wala na nasabi sa inyo. Kaya dapat, kung gaano kayo katagal maglista ng petisyon sa ating Panginoon, ganun din dapat katagal nyo binibigyan ng permiso, oportunidad, pagkakataon si Jesus na magsalita sa inyo, magkwento naman sa inyo. At papaano nyo ginagawa yun? Alam nyo, si Lord, hindi basta si Lord eh. Pag tayo nagsasalita, hindi nagsasalita si Lord. Hindi siya bastos. Ginagalang niya tayo. Kaya, magsasalita lang si Jesus pag tayo ay tatahimik. Okay, pwede siguro, Lord, ito po yung aking mga pangangailangan, ito po yung aking gustong sabihin sa inyo. Okay, ngayon naman po, gusto ko marinig kung ano yung sasabihin nyo sa akin. Tatahimik po ako. Hindi ako mag-iisip ng kung ano. Tatahimik po ako. Makikinig po ako sa inyong sasabihin. Pero kung nasa isip mo habang ikaw ay matahimik, kung ano yung iluluto mo, kung ano yung kakainin mo, kung ano yung schedule mo mamaya, kung ano yung panunuorin mo sa TV, hindi po kayo matahimik. Nagsasalita pa rin kayo, pero sa isip nyo, hindi sa bibig. Kailangan tahimik din ang inyong kaisipan. Dapat tahimik din ang inyong kapusuan sa inyong puso para mabigyan yung pagkakataon si Jesus magsalita sa inyo. Ganyan po ang tunay na BFF. Magsasalita kayo, kakausapin nyo si Jesus, pero bibigyan yung pagkakataon si Jesus na magsalita naman sa inyo. Ano ang mensahe ni Jesus sa inyo for today? Mamayang gabi, Jesus, ito po ang nagawa ko. Lord, ito ang nagawa ko. Agreeable ba kayo? Tama ba ginawa ko? Sige, pakikinggan ko po kayo. Tatahimik ako sa isip, sa wika, at saka sa ating kadamdamin. At doon lang sa katahimikan magsasalita ang Panginoon sa atin. Gawin natin po itong isang ensayo. Pagkatapos ng homily ko, sasabihin ko po sa inyo, pumikit kayo, manahimik kayo, huwag niyong pansinin ang ingay at galaw sa paligid ninyo, isipin ninyo, Panginoon, ano po ba ang gusto niyong sabihin sa akin? Hindi kayo mag-iisip ng kung ano ang inyong gagawin o anong gustong isipin, wala. Blanco isip, blanco sa kanan. Panginoon, ano po ang inyong sasabihin? Mag-ensayo tayo for about a minute or two. Saglit lang. Ngayon, magsipikita kayo mga mata, iyuko nyo yung mga ulo, kalimutan yung ingay ng jeepney, ng mga ano sa kapaligiran, katahimikan lang, wala kayo sa isip, wala kayong sasabihin kay Lord, makikinig tayo sa isang minuto. Ngayon, iniimbita ko ngayon, huwag kayong tumingin sa akin, baka ma-distract kayo sa aking kulot na buhok at guwaping na mukha. Pumikit kayo, yumuko kayo ngayon. Yumuko kayo at pumikit kayo. At sabihin nyo, Panginoon, sama-sama sabihin natin, Panginoon, lakasan nyo po, Panginoon, makikinig kami sa inyong sasabihin.
Please all stand.
Dear friends, let us pray to God our Father, who has called us, all his daughters and sons, to become free in his Son, Jesus Christ. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That Christians may regard the commandments of God as doors to freedom from sin and evil. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who work in law enforcement and government may consistently place the welfare of the people above legalistic concerns. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That in worshiping the God who we cannot see, we may not forget our needy brothers whom we see. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord may heal those who suffer from various physical and spiritual maladies. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the dead may now rest in the company of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, every command of yours be to us an invitation to love and to serve everyone, to understand and to respect, to guide and be guided. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Lord, we lift up to you, for these gifts we offer for your glory. We will eat this living bread, we will drink this saving cup, and feel your presence, O Lord. As we offer this bread and as we bring you this cup, bless them, Lord Jesus, feed us now, give us life, send us your Spirit, the source of our lives. Together we will serve you with love.
Please all stand.
Pray, my dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
As we honor the memory of the mother of your Son, we pray, O Lord, that the oblation of this sacrifice may, by your grace, make of us an eternal offering to you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, and to praise, bless, and glorify your name on the feast of our blessed, of the Blessed Ever Virgin Mary. For by the overshadowing of the Holy Spirit, she conceived your only begotten Son, and without losing the glory of virginity, brought forth into the world the eternal light, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, the angels praise your majesty, dominions adore and powers tremble before you. Heaven and the virtues of heaven and the blessed seraphim worship together with exaltation. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in humble praise, as we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of God hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Peace on you.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also, brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, especially Noel, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and martyrs, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let us now pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to the apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you.
Peace with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please all kneel.
Dear friends, this is Jesus, Son of Mary, the Lamb of God who grants us life and love. Blessed are we who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Para sa lahat ng tatanggap na banal ng komunyon, sasagot po tayo ng amen pagkasabi ng pari o ng lay minister ng katawan ni Kristo at isubo agad sa bibig bago umalis sa harapan ng pari o lay minister. Sumunod po tayo.
Jesus, meek and humble of heart, hear me, deliver me, O Jesus. From the desire of being esteemed, from the desire of being loved, from the desire of being extolled, deliver me, O Jesus. Jesus, meek and humble of heart, hear me, deliver me, O Jesus. From the desire of being, O Lord, from the desire of being praised, from the desire of being preferred to others. Deliver me, O Jesus. Jesus, meek and humble of heart, heal me, deliver me, O Jesus. From the desire of being consulted, from the desire of being approved, from the fear of being humiliated, deliver me, O Jesus. Jesus, me and humble of heart, hear me, deliver me, O Jesus. From the fear of being despised, from the fear of suffering rebukes, from the fear of being calumniated, deliver me, O Jesus. Jesus, me and humble of heart, hear me, deliver me, O Jesus.
Pagkatapos ng misa, wiwisikan po ang lahat ng banal na tubig. Pinakikiusapan ang lahat na manatili lamang muna sa inyong mga lugar. Tanging sa Quezon Boulevard o sa Plaza San Juan lamang ang labasan ng lahat. Sumunod po tayo. Maraming salamat po sa inyong pagdalaw at pagsisimba sa Basilica Minor at Pambansang Dambana, ni Jesus Nazareno. Please all stand.
Let us pray. Having been made partakers of eternal redemption, we pray, O Lord, that we who commemorate the mother of your Son may glory in the fullness of your grace and experience its continued increase for our salvation. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. Blessed are you, O God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. You have given us your only Son to be our way to you. Make us follow him generously, faithfully, and lovingly. Merciful Jesus of Nazareth, you have revealed God's grace and unconditional love for us at the cross. You set your church in this world from which true light would shine for all to see. Grant that we who enter this holy shrine may walk in your ways as disciples of justice, peace, mercy, and hope. We offer our prayers for the sick, the oppressed, the youth, and those in need most of your mercy. Hear our humble petitions. Bless those religious articles that we may be fervent in prayer and charity. as we continue our journey as your pilgrim people on earth, may we set our hearts on the road to heaven, our true home and reward, where you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Padre Jesus Nazareno, sinasamba ka namin, pinipinto ka namin, paral mo ang aming buhay at kaligtasan. Padre Jesus Nazareno, iligtas mo kami sa kasalanan. Ang krus mong pinamatayan ay sa isag ng aming kaligtasan. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, inuwalhati ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, dinarangal ka namin. Nuestro Padre Jesus Nazareno, inuluwalhati ka namin.